Karen here from Gold Bio, and I am talking about keeping a good lab notebook. This is very important for manuscripts, presentations, collaborations, and even just your future self. So if you are new to keeping a lab notebook or you just want some tips and tricks, stick around. Tip number one is just understanding the purpose of the lab notebook. When you understand its purpose, you're automatically going to be in the mindset of taking better notes. And the purpose of your lab notebook is just keeping a very, very detailed record of everything that you did in the lab so you can take all that information and use it towards your publications or presentations in the future. It's a record of what you did, how you did it, why you did it, what you used, everything. And then the other purpose of the lab notebook is this is a great tool for either your future self, if you're trying to recall what you did, or someone else, maybe a colleague or a collaborator or anybody else who needs your lab notebook, they now have a manual and can understand how to set up the experiment. So the more detailed you are, the better you empower that person to be able to clearly take on that experiment and get the same results. The second tip is avoid bad habits. And the first bad habit is not reading regularly in your lab notebook. And I know it's really tough because the lab notebook has to be structured, you need to write neatly, and then you have everything else going in the lab. But if you don't write regularly, you're going to end up getting backlogged, and a lot of the information that you need to put in there is now not going to be as detailed because you're spending too much time trying to recall all of that. The next bad habit is using post-it notes, scrap paper, or paper towels for your in-the-moment notes. And the reason this is bad is because anything that you're writing on something like this is just not going to be detailed enough for your lab notebook. Plus, you run the chance of losing it or it getting damaged, like spills and things like that. And then another bad habit is like scribbling out a paragraph or sentence. You want to be able to read what you wrote in the past because sometimes you're going to need to recall that information to help guide and help you understand like what you wrote next. Furthermore, this is considered an official document, so when you're scribbling it out, it almost gets rid of that idea of transparency. So instead, just make clean lines through sentences that you just want to get rid of. And then the last bad habit is thinking of your lab notebook as a chore. This is not a chore, it is a tool. So if you frame your mindset that this is a tool, this is going to help me with my future presentations, my future projects, my future publications, that's going to help you be really good about taking good notes. The third tip is just checking with your institution. A lot of times they have really good resources online, so it's not just to understand what the requirements are, but to see what kind of tips and tricks that they have. The fourth tip would be check with your PI. This is not just to understand what the requirements are, which hopefully were communicated to you in the very beginning, but to find out what they think makes a good lab notebook. They have a lot of experience and expertise, and they have seen a lot of notebooks. So find out what they think are strengths and weaknesses for keeping a lab notebook, things that they found that helped them write regularly. Maybe they even have examples that you can look at of like what a good notebook looks like and what a not so good notebook looks like. Tip five is keep a bound secondary notebook. This is so important because you really do have to take notes as you're going, and it is sometimes really hard to make nice, clean notes and structured notes in your lab notebook. And again, you don't want to use paper towels or post-its, so instead, have a secondary notebook. It gives you a lot more pages to use, so you're going to be more inclined to writing more detail as you're going, and then you don't run the risk of losing information. Now, some things to keep in mind about this, however, is your institution may not allow it. It could be seen as a security risk, so double check with your institution or your lab. And then another thing is, while you can be a little bit sloppier and unstructured with this, you don't want your notes to be so sloppy that you can't read it. And then anything that you put in here, you still have to transfer over here. So something that's really important is dating your notes here, and then also I would recommend putting a title down that corresponds to the title in your actual lab notebook. The sixth tip is keeping a wider margin. If you can't keep that secondary notebook. And this is something a grad student taught me, which was a huge lifesaver. But if you expand your margin in your lab notebook, then you have a place for those in-the-moment notes. So like condition changes or observations or just, you know, a random thought of something that you need to do. You can put that all down here. And then the nice thing is it's already dated. It's already in kind of with your major entries. And then all you have to do is if it needs transferred over, you can. Now the downside is you leave yourself a little space. So if this isn't gonna work for you, the other thing that you could do is just dedicate the back pages to keeping those notes. The seventh tip is to make it a point to write daily. And really what this means is putting a time block out there for yourself. So if 4 o'clock is your time to write in your lab notebook, then you really, really want to be strict about this. It's so easy to fall out of habit. So when you're writing daily, another thing that you want to keep in mind too is use this period to also review. And the reason that reviewing alongside writing is going to be so helpful is it'll allow you to look at your experiment in a different way. It'll give a lot more context and dimension. And so you might be asking deeper questions now, or you may have other ideas of a better approach to use. So block a time out and make this lab notebook time. So the eighth tip is making sure you write as you go, because it's going to help you identify whether you've missed steps. It's going to be a great troubleshooting resource. So what you want to do is write down what you're doing while you're doing it. For instance, let's say you run a gel and you didn't get results and you're trying to figure out what happened. Well, if you wrote as you went, and let's say you taped in the PCR mix that you used and you were checking it off and you noticed that you didn't check off the primers, then you know exactly where you went wrong. Tip 9 is tape. Tape or glue, and what's really helpful is double-sided tape. This is something I kind of understood in undergrad, but not to the level that would have been really helpful. So in undergrad, I would tape in my pictures of my gel, but I was writing down my protocols over and over, and then I would just get super lazy and just go, oh, I use this protocol, which is not what you wanna do. So instead, you can tape in your protocols and then check things off as you go, or if you've changed conditions about your protocols or are trying to optimize it, you can just write that in. And then the other thing is you can tape in data sets, you can tape in sequences, things like that. Just one thing to do if you're gonna do this is date it, and you may also have to have it signed off. So definitely get clearance and understand what your lab requires. The 10th and final tip comes from MIT's Department of Mechanical Engineering, and they pose 2 questions that if you can answer yes, then you are keeping a good lab notebook. So the first thing that they want you to think about is if somebody with your experience and expertise can pick this up and go through it, make sense of it, run the experiment, and get the exact same results, then you have kept a good lab notebook. And then the second thing they want you to consider is, if you in the future can pick this up, make sense of it, either run the experiment again, or use it towards your manuscript, then you have kept a good lab notebook. So that's it. Those are the 10 tips. I do have actually more information in an article online at goldbio.com, and I will also put the link below. So the last thing I would say is if you have your own tips and tricks, definitely comment below, or if you have stories of aha moments with your lab notebooks or nightmares with your lab notebooks, definitely share below. All of that's going to be helpful for everybody else looking at how to keep a good lab notebook. I hope you enjoyed the video. Definitely give us a like, subscribe, and share if you did. Thanks for watching.